Blackstone Audiobooks presents, from the unabridged collection A.A. Milne's Pooh Classics, the 35 poems and verses from Now We Are Six, performed by Peter Dennis. This is the only reading of these delightful verses, authorized by A.A. Milne's son, Christopher Robin.
Now We Are Six. To Anne Darlington, now she is seven, and because she is so special. Introduction. When you are reciting poetry, which is a thing we never do, you find sometimes, just as you are beginning, that Uncle John is still telling Aunt Rose that if he can't find his spectacles he won't be able to hear properly, and does she know where they are? And by the time everybody has stopped looking for them, you are at the last verse, and in another minute they will be saying, "Thank you, thank you," without really knowing what it was all about. So next time you are more careful, and just before you begin you say, "Hem," very loudly, which means, "Now then, here we are," and everybody stops talking and looks at you, which is what you want. So then you get in the way of saying it whenever you are asked to recite. And sometimes it is just as well. And sometimes it isn't. And by you find yourself saying it without thinking. Well, this bit which I am writing, called Introduction, is really the "hem" of the book. And I've put it in, partly so as not to take you by surprise, and partly because I can't do without it now. There are some very clever writers who say that it is quite easy not to have an "hem," but I don't agree with them. I think it is much easier not to have all the rest of the book. What I want to explain in the introduction is this. We've been nearly 3 years writing this book. We began it when we were very young, and now we are six. So, of course, bits of it seem rather babyish to us, almost as if they had slipped out of some other book by mistake. On page whatever it is, there is a thing which is simply three-ish. And when we read it to ourselves just now, we said, "Well, well, well," and turned over rather quickly. So we want you to know that the name of the book doesn't mean that this is us being six all the time, but that it is about as far as we've got at present, and we half think of stopping there. Alan Alexander Milne. P.S. Pooh wants us to say that he thought it was a different book, and he hopes you won't mind, but he walked through it one day, looking for his friend Piglet, and sat down on some of the pages by mistake. Solitude. I have a house where I go when there's too many people. I have a house where I go when no one can be. I have a house where I go when nobody ever says no. When no one says anything, so there is no one but me. King John's Christmas. King John was not a good man. He had his little ways, and sometimes no one spoke to him for days and days and days. And men who came across him when walking in the town gave him a supercilious stare, or passed with noses in the air. And bad King John stood dumbly there, blushing beneath his crown. King John was not a good man. And no good friends had he. He stayed in every afternoon, but no one came to tea. And round about December the cards upon his shelf, which wished him lots of Christmas cheer and fortune in the coming year, were never from his near and dear, but only from himself. King John was not a good man, yet had his hopes and fears. They'd given him no present now for years and years and years. But every year at Christmas, while minstrels stood about, collecting tribute from the young for all the songs they might have sung, he stole away upstairs and hung a hopeful stocking out. King John was not a good man. He lived his life aloof, Alone, he thought a message out while climbing up the roof. He wrote it down and propped it against the chimney stack. To all and sundry near and far, F. Christmas in particular, and signed it not Johannes R., but very humbly, Jack. I want some crackers, and I want some candy. I think a box of chocolates would come in handy. I don't mind oranges, I do like nuts, and I should like a pocket knife that really cuts. And oh, Father Christmas, if you love me at all, bring me a big red India rubber ball. King John was not a good man. He wrote this message out and gat him to his room again, descending by the spout. And all that night he lay there, a prey to hopes and fears. I think that's him a-coming now. Anxiety bedewed his brow. He'll bring one present anyhow, the first I've had for years. Forget about the crackers, and forget about the candy. I'm sure a box of chocolates would never come in handy. I don't like oranges, I don't want nuts, and I have got a pocket knife that almost cuts. But oh, Father Christmas, if you love me at all, bring me a big red India rubber ball. King John was not a good man. Next morning, when the sun rose up to tell a waiting world that Christmas had begun, and people seized their stockings and opened them with glee, and crackers, toys, and games appeared, and lips with sticky sweets were smeared, King John said grimly, "As I feared, nothing again for me. I did want crackers, and I did want candy. I know a box of chocolates would come in handy. I do love oranges. I did want nuts. I haven't got a pocket knife, not one that cuts. And oh, if Father Christmas had loved me at all, he would have brought a big red India rubber ball." King John stood by the window and frowned to see below the happy bands of boys and girls, all playing in the snow. A while he stood there watching, and envying them all, when through the window big and red there hurtled by his royal head, and bounced and fell upon the bed an India rubber ball. And oh, Father Christmas, my blessings on you fall, for bringing him a big red India rubber ball. Busy. I think I am a muffin man. I haven't got a bell. I haven't got the muffin things that muffin people sell. Perhaps I am a postman. No, I think I am a tram. I'm feeling rather funny and I don't know what I am. But round about and round about and round about I go. All round the table in the nursery, round about and round about and round about I go. I think I am a traveller escaping from a bear. I think I am an elephant behind another elephant who isn't really there. So...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.